Now that we've built that sample, we need to test and verify that it meets our target specifications.
We're going to do two types of testing. One is done when we're designing and building a speaker, and that actually verifies a lot of the electromechanical, acoustical parameters of the loudspeaker design. And we're going to be using a piece of equipment that is made by Klippel, and this gives us what are known as small signal parameters, or also known as lumped parameter measurements. The Klippel test will give us data such as what is the DC resistance of the coil, what is the Q, what is the VAS, what's the sensitivity, what's the BL. It gives us a number of parameters, some of them which are primary to the design and some of them which are secondary, but helpful information for the engineer to know what the design is actually producing.
Sometimes we'll build two or three samples and get a range, so that way we know, okay, if we use these parts, what is it going to do and what type of variation are we going to see. Once we've done that and it meets all of the customer's expectations as well as our design engineer expectations, we can move on to production.
We test a number of parameters at the end of the production line, and it's important to note that the speaker has to pass every one of those tests before it's moved on to the next step or shipped to the customer. And this level of end-of-line testing is very unique to MISCO. Most companies will do a very, very brief check to make sure the speaker operates, to make sure it doesn't have any noises, rubs, or buzzes, and to make sure it seems about loud enough. But at MISCO, we're actually measuring all of those things to make sure that they meet the specifications that the customer is expecting.